Hey everybody, it's Probably Red. We are going back into the league. We are returning. We're gonna open some booster packs. We're gonna play some games. This is the last week of Dead or Alive League. This has been a very smooth. I mean, not necessarily like. Okay, so let me rephrase that. It's been really easy to play the matches. It's been fun. It's been easy to engage with the actual game. I know last week it was five games, or more like this week. But anyways, yeah, the recording's been crazy. But it's been pretty good league, honestly. As I said, next month we're going to be taking some time off. And of course, they might. Yeah, I mean, that's subject to contingency, but most likely, like, the plan is we're not playing it. They put out like the most amazing card back ever and all this stuff, and it's just like the perfect pack combination or something like that. I can't really imagine what scenario it would have to be for me to want to come and play that next one after saying I'm not going to play it. We'll see if it happens. I don't think it's going to happen. Anyways, because I got other stuff planned. Got some other stuff I'm trying to do as far as YouTube goes. So let's see what we got here. All right, so we got to keep in mind we're at Stonescar. Magnificent Treasure is a good card, but it's not Stonescar. So we're kind of just going to look at the Stonescar cards. Anything else that's crazy might be noteworthy. Nothing that really stands out. It's actually, like, if you really think about it, Bladecrafter is pretty good. Maybe not in our deck specifically. The Book Club Yeti isn't as good, I feel like, in Sealed. Purpose Chant's pretty good. Other than that, I mean, Rageheart Paladin's a playable card if you're in Justice. Yeah, I mean, Magnificent Stranger, it's a pretty low power pack, I would say. From Within. Okay, Charge and Decay is pretty good at fast speed, you know, kind of like a fast speed deadly in some ways, because it turns your unit into a debuff. That's nice. The other ability just you're not getting, so it's a nice, like, I might swap this out for one of the tricks or fast spells we're using right now. I'm not using the Curtain Calls. I think it might have been the wrong move. I think the only thing that's holding them back, really, is that they're kind of high on power cost without you tapping into time. And then the Devil Shadow, just pretty taxing. We got a Grizzled Quickshot. We have plenty of Grizzled Quickshot. Oh. Game glitched out. What's going on? No. Misclick. Okay, we're good. Hopefully that didn't jack up the video. I hate when that happens. Anyways. Yeah. So we're doing good. We're fine. Yeah. Sorry I got distracted by that. There's a lot of Primal in this pack. So pretty much the only thing I could consider was maybe if we're putting in the Curtain Calls, we could put in the Curtain Calls and then From Within. Let's see, is there anything that we want to remove is the real question here. We got, we're 1100, that's not bad. Okay. So I feel like we're an aggressive deck. Like, we're very aggressively centered. Late game, we got a couple of, like, finishers that can get the job done. This kind of, like, is a draw card, get a big body, ping something. Or it's just, like, a big body for the late game if you happen to have it early in a hand or something. Like, it could be nice top deck late game. Okay, I actually kind of like the Trail Torch Cinderpaw. It's pretty good with some of these, like, early sustaining one drops and stuff. Like, I think some of these ones got potential. It might be something we removed, but we have to, like, I mean, it works really well with the Towering Arachnid. But then I could see me getting rid of the Towering Arachnids too, but they're a good part of the deck. Lurking Brew's good too. Overeating Mini Pod's probably not the greatest card there. That's worth considering. I like the Volatile Grenadines. They're just, like, a little powerhouse. Spirit Weave is great with all the potential five power units. Hired Gun might be a weaker include. We might need more tricks for it to be good. Like, we're only on a Relentless Pursuit. Anyway, we got a lot of units, don't we? Like the Red Mask Warriors pretty well. Like, I mean, I'm pretty comfortable with this deck. Is there anything that's just calling my name in here? We'll look. We'll give it a last run through. I mean, I like the Corrosive Dagger so much. I like Relentless Pursuit, but I don't think it's worth two includes, you know? Do we have any weapons in here? Oh, we could. Oh, hey. Is it Relic Weapon? Man, Blade Crafter could be another copy of our Corrosive Dagger. And I think I do want that. I like that card so much. Other than that, though, I don't think there's too much gonna happen. What do we want to get rid of? It's also a decent, like, sacrifice fodder, you know. We could probably cut a really mini bot, right? That doesn't hurt us too bad, yeah. Gives a little bit of late game action, interaction, whatever you want to call it. I mean, it's great. We have 7 powers. Wow. And a bunch of fire influence. That could be good. Anyways. So I know we didn't make many changes, but you know, we're late into the month here. We are getting close to the end. All right, we're up against Adira. Adira. Anyways, we could just, you know, drop the Oni Ronin and start swinging and hope for the best, but we're gonna redraw that. We want to play our good stuff. We want to play the big stuff. I need to relook the shadow balance here, because I don't want it to go like that. I don't want it to go with no shadow influence. Overall, this is a pretty solid hand. We can get one influence. We can play our whole hand, basically. Okay. Sir, hello. Oh, there they are. I don't have a hello, like, option. Guess we'll go fire symbol. We'll do that. Then we'll go lurking brute. Should we still go lurking brute? Yeah, we'll still go lurking brute. That means they can't attack. Transform into a sentinel. Okay, yeah, it becomes a big unit. Don't know. I think it's great, but I think it's pretty darn good. Let's play that first. Let's go with the Red Mask Warrior. We can decay that. I know it's kind of like showing, like, oh hey, look what we got. I want to do that number right there. That's not really worth it, but it's what we're gonna do. It's what we're gonna do. I know what's about to happen. They're about to play that 2-drop Alchemist. We can devour. Nope. Okay, I didn't do it. Let's just imbue this. Yeah, let's just imbue this. Swing for 10 next turn. And if they want to kill it, they can. Double. One more time. Drop this. Got a good defensive going. Yeah, they play like a 1/6 or a 2/6 or something. We're good. Oh, we'll go ahead and attack out. I think I'm just gonna sack this. Make sure we got some, like, maybe some removal or something going on. We'll go with this number because it guarantees us our. Okay, this is a push too. 5-2 with overrun's pretty solid. We're up against Shed. Oh, I like that hand. Triple fire influence, 2 shadow influence. Okay, now that's a good balance. This has got some potential. It's like a kind of risky hand with the triple, and we already got the 4. We'll see. We'll see how it goes. That's the thing. It's always blunder. getting rid of this to turn something into a situation that's not very efficient. But hey, suppose you gotta do what you gotta do. Worst case scenarios, two costs hits him in the face for four. I don't want to sack it. I want to play my vault on ground. I should have played the fire sigil just in case I top deck a fire sigil. Good, I didn't top deck a fire sigil. I'll drop red mask. We'll be as aggressive as possible, pushing the damage. Maybe they'll grant us a 5-5. Amazing. I put on a lot of pressure. Of course, first things first is do this number. Swing in. Okay. Yeah, we'll go this number. So we have 5. We could go Towering Arachnid and Silver Blade Reaper. Probably zacking something we don't want. Probably a Silver Blade Reaper. But, I mean, that's a little bit of push. Oh no. Okay. Okay. Well, dang. Begin. Okay, just, you know, push some aggression across the board. I'll take the damage. We'll just swing out. They'll kill something with a deadly unit, most likely. Honestly. Kinda. Maybe I attacked a bit too aggressively there. Because 11 turn clock is not right. Okay. Just get rid of this. We're gonna turn that into a 3-3. Next turn we'll be able to drop this down. That's a lot of damage coming in, isn't it? Use it on that wife steal, you know? Is this? Ooh, hey. Yeah, that could be good. We don't have the power to do it, though. Huh. We'll go with that. We'll swing out though, so they could take out two units. For sure. They'll take a good bit of damage. Nope, they can't take out that. I think they didn't know that. But then yeah, they probably would have taken the 4-1 out anyways. Because that's decay. Okay. So we'll do at least 3 damage. Now we draw a sigil, we can play both cards from our hand. That'll be good too. What is our opponent thinking about? Their removal can be bad, but we got a giant 13-4 and a couple of nicely sized units. Oh, that's not good. I think a spell they use there. they can get the influence up. They're doing pretty good. I think we just need to drop the Tentacles and go on the hyper defensive. Yeah. Just then go ahead and block. Okay. Okay. So we are up against I cannot exactly read that name. But on the right side we have an Odie Ronin. Yeah, I forgot to click the record button for this one. That's okay. This happens once in a while. Usually I'd cut the game, but maybe this will be an excellent game, so don't miss it. Swing in for two. We are damaging. So we have pass value question delayed so quickly, or so long. We can trade. We're going to shadow. That'll help us out a bit. This is a 6-4 would be pretty good, I would say. I'm gonna swing. Let's devour it. That's intense. Okay. Yeah, let's just make this a 0-1. I mean, yeah. Prevents them from getting more cries. Whoa, okay, okay. That's a ping. How are we gonna do this? There we go. That'll work. That gives us a unit to put the Cursed Dagger on, get a 1-1, sack it to the Towering Arachnid. No. Yes. They have 2 damage? Okay, well, at least we're gonna damage them. That's worth it. Kind of messes it up. Hey, there we go. Problem solved. This having decay, that's a really good blocker now. Shadow symbol. We're gonna do this number. So we get a huge bonus. Maybe they double block. Both their units will die. Okay. A little bit. Oops. This should work. Okay, now there we go. Let's go face. Oh, just this 8 damage is pretty solid. Okay, now that's just These waves. Got there. Wait. Oh my gosh. I didn't even read Mokto. That's pretty late into the set, but dang it. That's a problem. That's a big problem. Wow. Glad we gained all that life, though. We need one removal spell. You got us on it. Basically a 3 turn block. The Mokto really messed us up. It's a good save. Wow, that Mokto came out of nowhere. I wasn't even thinking. I didn't want to believe it there for a second. Alright, so it's Dark Shade. We shall keep. Okay, they went down a card. That's unfortunate. That's a really great start for us. We got that sacrifice water going. This could be pretty good. Okay. Let's go with the early arachnid. We have everything fixed that we need. We don't need any less sigils yet. So we don't really need to plunder this early. Well, can't take any of that. So let's go ahead and pass. Fire sigil. Would we trade for a 2-2? Not likely. Okay, now send them with these. Get our 4 damage on the saber 4-2. And on your own. Let's save it. She gets us some very. We'll probably play Murky next turn, but. It's not actually. I mean, just. I was thinking chemical rounds, but I said Murky. Anyways. Well, I mean, I guess we will. Never mind. Good. Only the damage. Okay. They got, unfortunately, power screwed there. Well, they had 2, so fortunate. Up against the Shivering Isles. gonna redraw this. Okay, by Loney. It's actually a very bad hand. It doesn't look bad. But I think it's actually gonna be a pretty bad hand. We've got three cards. Eventually I might be able to play. We got 1/0/2. I'm gonna see how this goes. I mean, we have the, if we get some blunder cards, Tyrant Ragnar would be perfect. Oh yeah, definitely not going to, yeah, we're not gonna play that. We need a playable by turn 4. Then we get the vow, we get a free 2-2, card from super nice, but I don't see that, I don't know if that'll happen yet. Let's get rid of that. Make sure we have that second fire for our tattoo dragon. Okay. Let's get this. Let's get it right there. We'll definitely block with the 0/2 to draw a 2/2. There's always. Yeah, I mean, it's just to save us some damage and get us a good, high-quality attacker. Okay, this kind of changes things. First, well, yeah, not really. I think they'll probably take it to face. Okay. They might have removal. I mean, they pretty much have to. It's 5/5 life steal right now. Huh. I mean, you gotta sacrifice it anyways. This is kind of a similar effect of what just happened. Oh, they even sacked to kill it. Wow. And they countered the whole thing because they gained a life back. That was an intense play right there. Okay. Touche, whatever you say. I'm not speaking ill of my opponent, I'm just saying touche. That was a interesting play. Kind of blew my mind. I mean, I should be disappointed, it's a 2-drop. Okay. 6/2 with lifesteal. I'll just swing and trade for either of those units. Yeah, let's go dead and kill the 5/2. Oh, we're the 4/3/2. A main space here. Pretty good. I should play the Shadow Sigil first, that was a misplay. Okay, let's see. Last time it was like literally the last second mock though, which was very disappointing. Okay, this isn't that bad. Okay, we're good to go. Well, I mean, they gained some life, I didn't even notice. Yeah, surprised how it gained them life. Darn it. 2 more turns. Do not. Here, kidding. No. That's a pretty big unit. They have a lot of health, though. Okay. Decay helps. Play it like this so that we can definitely push for 2 damage. I drew it off the top. Rite Legionnaire. Free draw. We'll keep this. This is actually pretty good. This river is kind of non-bow with the tattooed dragon with iron gun. But we still like it. Yeah, we don't really care about anything. This is pledge or pledge dip. But it's not. We have our third fire, so let's go start getting some shadow going on. Honestly, I think that's a little bit safer just because. It's kind of complicated. That's a really good card. Okay. What do I do now? 4-1 decay? That seems good. Makes a giant unit right there. But life steal's a problem. We'll tag and then we can block the reprisal. Awesome. I get the 3-4 back so that we can trade with our 4-1. This is going pretty well. Lifesteal was kind of bad for us, but hey. What I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna drop this. And the next turn Bladecraft will make us a 2-2. Sweet. Trader the 1-1. I don't know about that. I don't know if we can activate that ultimate in this deck. I do not recall. It's been a minute since I really. We're gonna try to push in for damage. We need. Let's see, we got a 4-3 in the sky, so. That'd be like 8 hits. I don't know. I don't know if I'm doing the math right there. Could reduce the clock by taking Bladecrafter and getting the Corrosive Blade. And then we could drop down Spirit Weaver. Yeah, this could be good. Let's start with Bladecrafter. And, you know, honestly, we'll swing with a 4-1. We can go. We need to go Spirit Weaver first so we can plunder something. Yeah. Spirit Weaver. What do we really not need? I think it's a bit late for Lurking Brood at this point. So then let's go with Corrosive Dagger on this. And Do I need to drop anything? No. Just swing in. If they don't gain any life, the cannon barrel will finish them off. And then that'll speed up the clock too. Yeah, so that we got that. Well, it isn't really. We could swing out. Of course that will, but no, we can't now because of that. Darn. Okay. Yeah. So what we're gonna do is this number. In theory, we'll be avoiding all evasion. Oh no. That's just messed up, dude. Plan has been totally wrecked by one card. Well, a pair of cards. Well, three cards. Anyways, let's do this number. Okay, we'll go with hired gun. I'm in the turn. Severin. Holy crap, Severin's a big problem, isn't he? We can figure this out. So yeah, blockers, that means our three biggest units. So we're dealing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 6 damage. It's just A space. See how they block. Will I be able to kill Severin with the chemical rounds? Yeah. And we got some damage too. Kind of an odd way of doing this, but we gotta get rid of Severin so we're not gaining 3 life every turn. And then Mini's a great blocker. Okay, now I think I'll attack like this. So, in worst case scenario, yeah, I mean, we actually have to get a sigil. This is pseudo unlockable. Unless they want to give us some good value. Or at least the appearance of value. I don't have the sigil, but we did. I like that. Let's do that. What are we gonna get? I think the. I don't know, it's hard. Maybe not. Yeah, it's a pretty good card. Let's go with this. And this. No, I think it will catch on by now. We're just. I don't know, I got nervous for a second. Because they know we don't have anything. They don't know, but they probably suspect we don't have any trick. That's pretty nice to that right there. Get rid of the blocker. We can get 2 damage in. They can't block our 1-3 and kill it. Damage. We got 5-6 on the ground. I think the only thing we have is Fury Blade, honestly. Really, the 2-2 would be better than Fury Blade in some ways. Got some damage in. But if we really want the Fury Blade, we can get next turn. Game. We're up against Hansdark. Okay. Let's redraw that. Not exactly the hand we're looking for. Okay, this hand's got a little bit of removal. I mean, this is kind of like the hand of combos. But on the bright side, okay, we're just gonna play as aggressively as possible in the beginning. Our opponents into playing a little bit defensively, hopefully. And they're seeing fire, they're about to see some shadow. Let's drop this. If we drop the Slag Fury Berserker, it's just gonna look like really sad. That, on the other hand, is a progressive, strong card. There we go. That's 6 damage now. Ambush? Pause, okay. Let's do this number. Extra 2 damage. It's worth it, hey. Crystal Dagger might not seem like much, but man, it makes a difference, especially in this deck, man. I've been pretty lucky with this Stonescar build here. Okay. Well, let's go ahead and attack out. Got there. Good game. Wow. That was just super fast. We're up against MC. Can't read that. That's an extremely advanced looking kanji. So yeah, way beyond me. I could probably maybe get out a couple of like names of what their symbols are called. It doesn't tell me what they sound like or what they necessarily mean in context of everything else. But no, not even close. Okay. Let's see. Get Shadow Sigil for sure. Lurking Brute comes first. We'll go into the Dark Blade cut first. We've got a couple more rounds cleared away, making this like a survivable stat line. It's perfect. Killing something we really, really would like to kill. Getting our good old 3/3. Made that card worth it just now. Good card. And of course, Kimco rounds did what it's supposed to do, killing apprentice mages all day. That card's really, the Prism Mage is really good, that's why I say it like that. And realistically, we could just swing in. We'll trade something for that, get a little bit of damage on the way. Cutting it 2-for-1 there, really, but we're also getting damage through. We're running out of steam, though, very quickly. If we can get to that, though, put them on 3-turn clock, as long as they don't have the removal. I'm guessing removal's about to come though. Oh no, wait, did they play it for? I didn't pay attention. Let's do this. Will they take the 4 damage to the face? They did. That was smart of them, in my opinion. So now they'd be taking that more damage to the face. I mean, they can catch up. They can catch up. Okay, awesome. Got a damage in. Let's go Battle Driver. It's pretty solid over there. Put him at 7. We'll attack out. We'll see what we can do here. We can get 2 damages, we're gonna. Oh, there's our Valdrivers, so we can't do the pump. Okay, no worries. We're okay.
We're okay.
Okay, as long as they don't get their master, we are golden. If they have a removal spell, like our board clear, that's really bad for us. Okay, now they need to the chemical rounds. We're good to go. Game. Okay, what we got there. Alright, so this is going to be our last round. We're up against Manfrey. Let's redraw that. Okay, not super great. Got some removal, a bit of card draw, got a shadow symbol. We need more fires, and we need more, you know, early units. If we could drop this shadow sigil, then just get a 2-drop off the top there, I'd be super pleased. Hey, that's not actually that bad. We'll change our plans for that. Turn 2, we're going to go to Devour, get our 2-2, and then turn up that. Go Shadow Symbol, play our 2-2 Flyer. Okay, let's go. We can go Fire Sigil. Realistically. Will not block. I'll take 4. Okay. Let's go with Shadow Symbol. Play the 2-2 Flyer. And a good Nendro. I'll try a 2-2 for a 4-1, I mean. Blocking our 1-1s, so we need to push for damage. We can kill with the chemical rounds, but next turn we're playing a potential Town Arachnid 4-4 cutter combo. We'll take the 1. This is a lot of options. We're just getting every option we could possibly want. We'll just skip up on that. Swing it for 1. Lurking Brute. And get our sigil out. All we really need that. I mean, totally did not do what I said I was going to do there. I was about to play a Vorpal Cutter. But, hey. Subconscious took over. What can I say? And I will just go ahead and make that not do what it usually does. And then I'll eat this. Okay. So we do have a trick. Okay, that's fine. Nothing you killed. Oh wait, that's 3. Yeah, they could fight the they could fight the Lurking Brute and kill it. Okay, we could do some pretty nifty stuff here. So let's go ahead and attack out. What we're going to do is we're going to boost this with the 3-0, and then we're going to select for a Berserk Pit. Okay, because this gains attack proportional to our biggest unit. That kind of changes our plans, right? Yeah. Okay, so now. Wonder if the damage counts. Like, if it's like temporarily damage, if that affects them view. I have to do some testing on that. I didn't want to test it just then because I'm wanting a big unit, but. And then if they spend some removal here, I mean, if they don't have a unit, we kind of win because the 8-4, or if they don't have removal. But if they don't have remo if they have four cards in their hand, unless they're like flooded, which does seem like they are, then they should have a unit or removal as well. Those are the two things you want to have in your deck. Especially in sealed, like you should be able to, you can choose. You have a lot more variables, like a lot more options, I guess, in theory. Because you could open up garbage after garbage also, because you don't get to pick your picks. Okay, so if you enjoyed this video, go ahead and click that like button, subscribe. Next week, just a reminder for all those League fans out there. I know, like, it's kind of ridiculous that I am saying this to the League fans. But, like, okay, bear with me here. I'm not doing League next week. Next month. This is it. This is the League. But we will return to the League series at some point. I just want the that time slot to go to other, maybe not necessarily Mondays, Tuesdays, because I know this is coming out a little later. Just wanted to let you know there's other stuff on my channel. Like, we could do lore longs. This Friday we'll be getting back into the draft thing. Last week we took a break from the draft. I try to let people know basically when I'm like stop certain series temporarily. Now, stuff like the roguelikes that I do, if you're into roguelikes or Let's Plays, that kind of stuff, I really don't like to like have purposeful temporary stops, unless it's gonna be for a good bit. This is just like, I mean, a month just because of the nature of the type of setup it is basically. It's League. So this is basically just me ranting at the end of the video. Yeah. Thank you and have a great night.